Very warm good evening to all and welcome to today's webinar on the types of panchnamas. Panchnamas are there in the civil as well as criminal trial. Today we are going to deal with mostly on the criminal side, and there are many types of panchnamas. Mainly there are five, but as you study you will find there are more than five, but basics are five. When we go to criminal court, any of the courts, you will always find this panch aalela hai. You will hear in the Marathi words, ye panch aaya hua hai, panch ko examine karna hai. Now panch, the meaning of the panch is like five people. If you go to Sanskrit, it is panch means five. In the past there were a panchayat in our country which used to decide all the matters related to between the two people or any crime committed. So panchas are like god. But now as the British rule came, thereafter there were courts were established, and these panchas were not like panchayat. Still we have in some parts of the country panchayat is still there, but now we have panch in the court. Now when we call panch in the court, the panch does not mean anybody from the family or any person who will be nominated. Here the police normally decides who will stand as a panch. Now the word panch comes from the Sanskrit, and the meaning behind that, he will be one who will be guiding and who will be telling the truth before the court here. Now he should be impartial, he should be an independent person, and he should be a respectable person. They cannot just catch hold of anybody, the police. Police having the unfettered power to record the evidence, to record the witnesses' statement. But here when they call panchas, it should be independent, but it's not somebody they can pick up. So that's why many times the matters before the court in criminal trials fail, because the panchas are unable to say what actually happened at the scene of offense. And there are cases because of the panch could not establish that panch, whatever the statement was recorded, he or she could not say what happened before at the scene of the crime or at the incident place, or how the weapon was recovered, how the accused were arrested. And that time the accused lawyer, that the defense lawyer, can take the benefit of the same. That is why this panch, the panchal statement, when you go for a criminal trial, it is very important that you read the complete panchnama and you completely know the by heart and find out that either there is a discrepancy what he has spoken in the statement and what is actually he is giving the testimony evidence before the court. Now here, when we say panch, here it is not five people, here it is only mainly two. In one of the matter of the session trial, I found there were three panchas for some other reason. But normally there are two panchas. The idea behind that, if one of the panch is not available at a later period and only one panch comes in the session trial or magistrate court trial, the police and the court can take the help of that panchas, what has actually transpired on the date of incident or what has actually happened. And they can take it, it will be a, I would say, corroborative evidence, not a substantive piece of evidence. When we call it substantive, it will be like the main evidence. But here, it will always be corroborative evidence with respect to all the other material available in the criminal trial. Now, there are many types of the panchnamas. The first we would go for the spot panchnama. The name itself suggests spot means the place of incident. It is the simplest and easiest form of the panchnama, which is very easy to understand. So if you read for spot panchnama, normally we see if it is one page or two page, how much electricity was there, whether if it is a murder or something happened in the night, incident taken place in the night, then was there enough light? Was it, if it is in daytime, was there enough sunlight also? Or there was a lamp post there, if it is an accident case, what were the shops around? What was the things around, whether there were people around. It can be that people are coming and going if it is an accident case. So spot panchnama is always about the place of incident. It may be somebody's house if it is a murder trial, if it has happened in a dwelling house. So it is spot panchnama is the place where the incident had taken place. Now suppose the depth, there is a theft in somebody's house, then they will be seeing lockers, what is the position of lockers, how are the chairs, furniture, what is disturbed. If it is a accident case on the roadside, they will always see what is the, if there are blood on the road, there are a divider on the road, how the road was there, and what, where, whether there are shops, what is the, it is north or south or it is east or west. They will try to see everything, all this place. So spot panchana is quite easy, but then you have to always see that whether from the spot panchana also the police have recovered anything. One, number two, if it is an accident case, what is the scene of the offense there? If there was blood on the road, you have to also check all these things when you do read the spot panchanama. It is one of the easiest form, but then also you should go through it very carefully, thoroughly, because you never know, spot panchanama may also help you. Because if one of the pancha says, if there was no lamppost, there was no electricity, if accident happens at 2 o'clock in the night, and there was no divider, or there were no tire this marks on the road, you should see whether he could have seen the car number. Sometimes when say, I've seen the also car numbers also, through what which accident has taken place. This is spot panchanama. Next is memorandum panchanama. This is one of the very important panchanama on which sometime acquittal can also be granted and conviction can also be granted. Normally, it is the admission of the guilt. The accused say that I have committed an offence and have committed an offence with this some weapon, he will show you. And he will say that this weapon I have hidden here, or I have thrown in an open place, or I have hidden below the tree. So this is memorandum panchanama. So if you read the constitution, always the article 20 will say that nobody should be allowed to stand as a witness against his own itself, myself. I cannot be asked to stand as a witness against my own self. But this is one exception, and it has been reiterated and also confirmed by the Supreme Court that in memorandum panchanama, this is allowed. Though it is recorded by police, but it is one of the very serious panchanama which you should take very note of the same. And when you go for memorandum panchanama, kindly read it twice, thrice, four times, and see what is actually the punch is giving the testimony in the court. Now, it is mostly about the admission of the guilt that I have committed the crime. And he will say that with this weapon I have committed, and this weapon is lying here and there. So it is also a seizure or recovery panchanama along with this. But memorandum panchanama is always about the guilt. Now, next we go to the seizure panchanama. Now, under seizure panchanama, as in seizure means to recover something. Now, when you are seizing something from the accused or from the witnesses, from the complainant, the police takes many things during the investigation. They recover many things. They may be taking anything from, maybe clothes, maybe any article from your home, if the offense has taken place at home or at the roadside, if there is a weapon and if this weapon is lying somewhere else, they may also recover it, because there will be nobody, but weapon is already there near the dead body. They will be taking that. So when they are seizing them, same. So they can see, when I, as a defense, I will always say, this weapon you have taken just from the police custody, you have just shown the weapon. This is a knife. We don't know, this kind of knives are available also in the market. This is a Rampuri Chaku in one of the murder cases. I will say Rampuri Chaku is available in the market. How do we know it was the same use in the same murder, same case? So they take the pancha's help, and with the in front of pancha, they will seize the same. They will put a cover on the same. They will put in envelope. They will also stick a label to it. This was recovered on so-and-so date. They will put a date, label, everything, and they will take pancha's signature on the same. And see, always panchanama is signed by two panchas and also the investigation officer, that's the IO. Now, next we go to inquest panchanama. Inquest panchanama is one of the easiest thing, but this panchanama again is very material and a vital part of the any investigation, and also the very important part of the charge sheet. If there is a death, it may be due to some crime, or maybe due to accident case, or maybe other some other reason, very suspicious nature. That time that dead body, when police comes, they do the inquest panchanama. And when they do the inquest panchanama, they will always take two pancha signature and they will always mention inquest panchanama, probable date of the death. See, oh, police is not a doctor, but they will always try to see what has happened actually, what the reason for the death, whatever, small death, maybe accident case. Police is not a doctor or medical officer. Still, they will write. They will also write how many injuries, if possible, to the naked eye that time before sending it to postmortem. So, inquest panchanama is conducted by police and is also one of the very important part. Postmortem is by doctors, but inquest panchanama is by the police. So, this is also one of the very important part of your criminal trial. Now, next, we go to the arrest panchanama. As the name itself suggests, it is about the arrest. Now, you must have read, there are many guidelines in most of the, in CRPC as well also through Supreme Court, many judgments. Supreme Court has said, whenever you are arresting a person, you should inform his relatives, his friends. So people are not in a, the person, they should not be put in fear. They should be allowed to contact their lawyers. Now, whenever arrest panchanama is done, a person is arrested, he is carried to the police station. His relatives, his family members, his friends, or his lawyer should be informed that such and such person is arrested. And when they are arresting a person, they will put an identification mark in arrest panchanama, which is mostly not done always. But if you see the FIR also, you will always find what is the identification mark of the accused, you will find. But arrest panchanama is different, that you will also find what is the physical appearance. Is a fair or is a not fair. He is a of some black color, dark, his complexion will be written in that. So arrest panchanama is also one of the important thing, and the timing of the arrest can be related to the crime and other things, recovery. So always remember that when you read arrest panchanama, always see the timing of the arrest. This may help you in many other aspects also. Now, apart from these five basic panchanama, there are many panchanama which we will also discuss. One, I would say that is Food Adulteration Act. Everybody knows that when food is adulterated and the food inspector comes from the government department. Now, this person takes the food articles of the shop in his possession. Now, he is not supposed to take the possession just like that. He will call the police and police will also have to punch us and to give the authenticity that actually he has recovered these goods. This may be some ghee ka dabba or whatever it is. Something adulterated food or some it is a kind of a some packets which are not authentic. There may be some cosmetics which are actually not authentic. This will be recovered. Now, while recovery is done, there will be a panchanama. So, in under Food Adulteration Act or some other things also, there will be a panchanama. And next, we go to foreign offences. Now, in, there are offences which are committed in the forest, on the forest land. It may be killing an animals, injuring animals, or cutting trees, something, entering some part of the forest where we are not allowed. Now, here also panchanama is drawn. Now, one thing you would like, I would like all of you to share while reading, even I came to know it today, that whenever an panchanama is made on the forest land, that is admissible under the law because of some law which is related to the forest laws, that whenever a panchanama is done on the forest land, it is admissible in the forest offenses. So it is very important whenever a panchanama is on the forest land. Now, next is very simple again, IP parade, identification parade of the accused. Now, when identification parade is made, then under test identification parade, what happens that we recognize the accused sometime. So that will be also a panchanama. If now the police cannot on their own say that complainant has recognized or victim has recognized this person. So there will be also a panchanama. There is also possibility of sample of blood is taken. Somebody sample, sometimes accused blood is taken and complainant blood is also taken to match. Sometimes handwriting is taken. Sometimes we will say specimen signature for the checks are also taken or in forgery cases. And these are also a panchanama, always remember. Also in accident cases, sometimes there is a condition of vehicle is in very bad shape. Now this vehicle cannot be taken to the place of the court and the again to the keeping in the police station is always difficult. In such kind of matters, they will have a panchanama on the condition of the vehicles. It may be along with the photographs and everything. Nowadays, previously also there were photographs, but if photographs are taken, the photographer has also to be examined in the criminal trial. And one very important panchanama I would like to tell all of you in anti-corruption matters. Now, if you all have read the newspapers, there is a pre-trap panchanama. There is always a trap in the anti-corruption matters. There is a pre-trap panchanama and post-trap panchanama. It may be the notes or cocaine, drugs, whatever it is. But then this is also a very important part in anti-corruption matters. This panchanama plays a very important role because whatever material is brought before the court, it is from these traps. So whenever you are running a trial of the anti-corruption, the panchanama plays a very big role. So all the panchanama, I think we have covered more than 10 panchanamas. And if we know all this, it will be actually really easy for us to go through the criminal trial and get an acquittal or get a actually real picture before the court. Now, does this panchanama have the evidentiary value? As I said in the beginning, it will not have the complete evidentiary value. It will have a corroborative evidentiary value. That means it will be in corroborative position. It's not a substantive piece of evidence completely, not the main. That is the original evidence. It is through the panchas. So if you have to break your case, you have to read the panchanama properly and you have to show the loopholes to the presiding officers or the court. What is the difference between actually what is written in the statement of the pancha and also what is actually he has spoken on oath and by swearing on. And this pancha is swearing, always remember. If the normal practice, if you say the panchas are actually the chaiwalas or the people who goes to the police station regularly, so police also finds very difficult to get the actually real panchas. So whoever is available, sometimes they take those panchas. And you should always ask the panchas the question. I will have a very separate session, what question we can put to the panchas. But the main thing is that you should know that this panch is actually independent person, respected person. He is you should ask what is the his profession. He may be simple chaiwala and he knows that police goes through his chai dukan every time, chai shop. So he has tea stalls, distilleries. They have to, it's not that they have to oblige, but sometimes they are the only person available and police has no recourse and some people are not ready to come forward as a panchas. Even if we are told to act as a panchas, don't know how many of us will be actually ready to stand as a pancha, to sign the panchanama and go to the court. In our country, it is the most difficult thing for the police. So sometimes they are actually compelled to take any person who is actually next available to the police station. So you should always ask when you're asking, is your shop next to the police station, police chowki? These are the questions you can put. Now I'll discuss two very important decisions of the Supreme Court. One is Subedar Tiwari versus State of UP. This is from the Supreme Court. Now here this offense took place in some 1984 and this was a bride burning case, dowry case. Now when a dowry that happened, you all know that 30B section was added or added to the Indian Penal Code in the year 1986. Now this incident of 1984. So all the dowry cases before 1986 November, they were all booked under 302 of the Indian Penal Code. Now bride burning cases after the amendment was done to the Indian Penal Code in 1986 November, 30B was added. Now in Subedar Tiwari was a state's case. If you read it, it's a very small case. I will give you only one incident from this case. That is about the matchbox because it's a bride burning case. Now, either matchbox and matchstick, commonly they will be in your kitchen. But here in panchanama, it was that these articles which were taken from the kitchen, she got burned in the kitchen. The wife got burned in the kitchen. But a matchbox and this, they were not in the kitchen. They were found elsewhere in the bedroom or some other places. Now, when we say that they, why they are not, there should be a probable explanation why the matchbox is not there. Now, in there were two accused in this. One was acquitted and one was convicted. So, this Panchanama played a very important role in this matter of the Supreme Court, Subedar Tiwari versus State of UP. Now, next matter is Sambhaji Hindu Rao Deshmukh. This I will would like to read. Just a minute. One para from this. So, you will have an idea what actually happens. This is a para 2.4. This is again from a case from Supreme Court. Sambhaji Hindu Rao Deshmukh versus State of Maharashtra of 2008. It is a, from the bench of J.P. Mathur and R.V. Ravindran. Author is Justice Ravindran. Both the cases are actually from Justice Ravindran. I am reading the para 2.4. Immediately thereafter, the IO, that is the investigation officer, went to Kusur village around 1:30 a.m. in the morning of 19 May 1988. He did not find anyone in the house of Ganpat. See, he did not find anyone in the house of Ganpat. The accused were also not dressed. He returned to the police station around 4:30 a.m. By then, Ganpat's another son, Ananda, reached the police station. The IO again went back to the Kusur village with Ananda and drew spot Panchanama. See, he drew the spot Panchanama. That is exhibit 33, under which blood stained stick and earth, mitti, smeared with blood, and some blood stained stones were recovered from the place of incident. See, under spot Panchanama, bhi kya recovery kya, that you should know. While drawing the spot Panchanama, the dead body of the Shivaji was found in the bathroom or in the kettle shed in front of the house. Now, see, dead body was found. So, inquest Panchanama was recorded as per Exhibit 27. This is second Panchanama in first one para. The dead body was sent for postmortem through Constable More, PW 60, that is a prosecution witness number 16. Thereafter, statements of Ganpat, Putlabai and Ananda, that is PW 12, 13, and 14, were recorded. During the search, the IO found even bamboo stick in front of the house of accused one, which was seized. This is seizure Panchanama, under Panchanama Exhibit 33, in the presence of PW 3 and 4. The blood stained clothes of PW 12, Ganpat and PW 9. See, Vilas were also I'm saying, adding it, seized under seizure Panchanama, Exhibit 23 and 24. Now, when we read this judgment, understand that there are three Panchanamas. In murder trial, there will be more Panchanamas also. There may be more seizure Panchanama. And if there are two bodies, there may be two inquest Panchanama. There may be three spot Panchanamas, because murder may have taken a place at somewhere place and the weapon is also thrown or hidden at some other places. Or the accused may have gone to another place. And he may also injured in the incident. And there may be here the earth was smeared into blood. That may also be taken away in the recovery. So during investigation, the police officer takes lot of material. And that is what the recovery Panchanama or seizure Panchanama. Now, this recovery is always about a weapon, normally. Or maybe clothes are also recovered. So always remember, these are very important parts. So whenever you are running a criminal trial or any other cases also, the Panchanama is one of the integral and important part of any trial. And in the criminal investigation, important part of the charge sheet. So today, I would say one of the very important part of the criminal trial is discussed. And if you read both this judgment, they are definitely going to enlighten you more about what is actually Panchanama and what important role it plays in the evidence and also the decision of the court in the verdict while deciding or giving a judgment of in the matter. This was all. I'm allowing you to unmute yourself. There is a question from Mohan. Ma'am, I remember there is a one case in which Supreme Court has let down that in serious cases, there should be at least one panchayat who is servant of government so that he cannot turn hostile. Can you please tell us the judgment of the guideline? I'm not or I'll try to find it out. Thank you so much. I'll find out. Suraj asking about discovery panchanama. Discovery is like a police is going there at the place of incident and they may discover something, they will recover it. It is same as that. Under section 27, when we are calling that is memorandum panchanama. See, memorandum panchanama, I will explain again. That is one of the important part. If you read article 20, a person is not supposed to stand as a witness against himself or herself. But there is one exception under the Evidence Act, that is under section 27, where the accused can say that I have committed this murder and I want to say that actually I have committed this murder. Now when he is saying this, the police may not have the access to the magistrate under section 3164 of CRPC to take him immediately. So they will call the two panchas immediately, and what they will do, they will record his statement and that he is saying that I have committed and he is accepting his guilt, and he may also further say that with this weapon I have committed and this weapon is elsewhere where he has hidden or where he has thrown. Hema is asking, ma'am, exhibit means, see, whenever any document is proved in the before the court, that is actually exhibited. So it is proven document. Any more questions? I have unmuted. We can discuss also. Anybody wants to? Yes, you can unmute, Suraj. You can unmute yourself.
Yes, ma'am. I have one question.
Yes, yes.
Suppose informant is saying as per the FIR, and also pancha is also saying as per the panchanamas. Then punishment can be given on that basis.
See, there will be also IO. Yes, yes. Possibly. What you are saying? See, informant is also saying as per the FIR. So there, you will not find any improvement omissions in his statement. Next, you are coming up on the panchanamas. Panchanama is about, if I have no idea what offense you are talking, is accident case or some trial of the murder or some weapon is used. If they are on the same path, they are not, they're speaking whatever actually written in panchanama and the first information report, then there is a likelihood of the conviction. So the word used in criminal trial is you have to break the panchas through your cross examination. Those who want to speak, they can unmute themselves. Yes, Archana.
Ma'am, if the accused is in the custody of a police and he admits that he has committed the offense and he had kept the weapon anywhere else,
that will be memorandum panchanama.
Yes, and whether
it has to be voluntary, that statement has to be voluntary. Because if you read the memorandum panchanama from any of the charge sheet available in your senior's office, just check that, or you go to the court, ask the court, Carpent Criminal Court, okay, let me read one of the memorandum panchanama. They will tell you the exact words where they say, I am voluntarily accepting that I have committed this murder or I have committed this offense.
But what will be the evidentiary value of his statement, ma'am? When he is saying that he has kept that weapon elsewhere.
When this panchanama, when this matter will go into trial, these both panchas will be called. And along with other evidence, this will be accepted.
Achha, achha. Yeah.
So read Article 20 also when you go for a memorandum panchanama.
Means the recovery of the weapon will also be proved, and offense committed by the accused will be also be proved.
True. But this both pancha has to come before court. But that yes, part, yes. See, always remember, there is a judgment which also says, which clarity, that part where he says, I have admitted my guilt, that part will be excluded. But the weapon recovery, which led to the weapon recovery, will be before the panchanamas. Okay, the part will be excluded. There is a judgment if you read it.
Oh, thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Dipti is asking about the seizure panchanama. See, Dipti, seizure means seizing the property. During the investigation, see if there is a theft in a house. The police may come and take so many things in their recovery. That is seizure panchanama. There is also a possibility the theft is committed. The thief are also arrested. From there also some ornaments are recovered. That will be also a seizure panchanama. Recovered from them, right? This is Nikita asking, in case of seizure panchanama, if nothing is recovered in case of dacoity, then can the statement sole victim be relied upon? No witnesses into the incident, 5 accused have stolen all the jewelry. See here, what you are saying that under panchanama, there is seizure panchanama, nothing is recovered. So normally when we go for bail, we always make one statement, sir, under panchanama, there is no recovery in this dacoity case, what you are talking. Now when you go for trial, there will be other witnesses also. If nothing is recovered from the accused, what was the reason they were arrested from the scene of offense? I have not read your charge sheet, but I am just making a submission on what you have written. And here this five who has stolen all the jewelry has put the jewelry in the bag and disappeared when the gas from AC pipe leaked. You can call me Dipti later on. Sashank is asking, ma'am, please took one lecture on criminal trial or stages of criminal trial. Sashank, I have already taken stages of criminal trial, but I will try to take in detail. Ma'am, can you help tell me about your pre-trip panchanama post-trip? Pre-trap panchanama and post-trap, it is like a trap is about anti-corruption. Whenever anti-corruption bureau, if you read the newspaper regularly, you will always find it under anti-corruption. Whenever a person is arrested, there is a trap let down that they will come and then anti-corruption bureau is informed, police is informed. Maybe bribe or something like that. Sometimes drugs, peddlers, they are also arrested. I'm thankful you all are attending, asking good questions. It is also enlightening my knowledge as well. Anybody wants to talk, they can talk. Unmute themselves, ma'am. Anybody has any questions? Okay, I'll put it off. Thank you so much. Thank you for attending. Thank you.